Hi friends, today we will study about photorespiration, which is also known as C2 cycle or photosynthetic carbon oxidation. In last video we have studied the carboxylase activity of Rubisco. Today we will study the oxygenase activity of this enzyme. Important points to be remembered pertaining to photorespiration. First, ribulose bisphosphate, its two molecules are oxidized into two molecules of phosphoglyceric acid and two molecules of phosphoglycolate. Second point, enzyme involved is Rubisco with oxygenase activity when oxygen concentration is more than CO2 concentration. Third point, this C2 cycle or photorespiration takes place in three cell chambers. One is chloroplast, next is peroxisomes, third is mitochondria. Fourth important point, glycolate will change into, this glycolate is a 2-carbon compound, this glycolate change into glyoxylate, glyoxylate changed into glycine, and glycine is finally converted into serine. So here glyoxylate is 2-carbon, glycine is a 2-carbon compound, and serine is a 3-carbon compound. That's why we take two molecules of RuBP and we produce two molecules of glycolate. So two molecule of glyoxylate, then two molecule of glycine, then one molecule of serine. So here one carbon is released in the form of carbon dioxide. Let's see the structure of these important chemicals. So just identify this chemical structure, which is of which chemical? This is RuBP. So one molecule of RuBP when oxidized is produced CH2O phosphate group, then COO CHOH CH2O phosphate. This is 3-carbon compound that we have studied in the C3 cycle. Now this is the chemical that is glycolate, and on this basis C2 cycle was named. Next is as we see this glyoxylate, and after glycolate, next compound is formed, that is COO minus CHO. This is glyoxylate. Next is the simplest amino acid that we know. As amino acid has one NH2 group and COH and H, then R is represented by as this is glycine. So two carbon. So here see, this is two carbon compound, this is two carbon compound, and glycolate is a two carbon compound. Now from glycine you just put CH2OH here, CH2OH, CHOH, then NH2, COH, so it will become the three carbon compound, first, second, third. Now it is serine amino acid. Now let's draw C2 cycle. So we start with the two molecules of RUBP, which are oxidized with two molecules of oxygen, then it forms two molecules of phosphoglycolate and two molecules of PGA are formed. So phosphoglycolate releases PI and forms two molecules of glycolate. Then again you write two molecules of glycolate, then two molecules of glyoxylate, then two molecules of glycine, then again two molecules of glycine. So now divide where we wrote two times glycolate and two times glycine. As we know that C2 cycle takes place in three chamber, one is chloroplast, one is peroxisome, and one is mitochondria. And we are starting with four carbon because two molecules of two carbon compounds are involved. So total carbon is four carbon. Now two molecules of glycine convert into three carbon molecule, which is amino acid, that is serine, that is a three carbon molecule, and one carbon is released in the form of CO2, one amino group is released, and one NADH2 is also released. Now serine three carbon can come back to peroxisome, and this serine converts into hydroxy pyruvate, then this hydroxy pyruvate forms glycerate, and glycerate comes back to chloroplast, and it receives one molecule of ATP, and it converted into PGA. And as we know that phosphoglyceric acids are the intermediate of C3 cycle, so they participate in the formation of RUBP and glucose. Now let's focus on some of the important enzymes involved in the C2 cycle. So this enzyme is Rubisco activities oxygenase that we have already discussed at this point. Now this reaction is catalyzed by phosphatase, because phosphate is released. Now glycolate, when converts into glyoxylate, this enzyme is glycolate oxidase that forms glyoxylate, and it releases two molecule of, because we are taking two molecules of glycolate, and it is detoxify with the help of catalase enzyme into oxygen and H2O. Now very important enzyme of the C2 cycle, that is CDC, that is glycine decarboxylase, because CO2 is released. Now glyoxylate to glycine NH2 will come in. Enzyme, you know, that is transfer of amino group, so it will be transaminase. Now this is not much important. Now hydroxypyruvate glycerate. Now one important enzyme you can write here, that is glycerate kinase. Now here it is the again transaminase, then here NH2 is released. Now hydroxypyruvate to glycerate, here involvement of dehydrogenase, here NADH2 is converted into NADH is converted into NAD plus, and this is the all about C2 cycle. Now let's discuss some of the important points which are emerged from this C2 cycle. So let's see some of the important points emerged from C2 cycle. First point, C2 and C3 cycle are interlocked and opposite processes. What does it mean? You write here there are the two important compounds, RuBP and PGA. These two are common in C2 and C3 cycle. So when RuBP takes CO2, it gets carboxylated and form PGA, and then PGA regenerates RuBP. This is the net gain in the C3 cycle when one molecule of CO2 is fixed. When RuBP is oxidized with oxygenase activity, then it forms glycolate, and then glycolate forms PGA. So this is the C2 cycle. So these are interlocked. Why we are saying? Because C3 cycle is independent in terms of RuBP regeneration, but C C2 cycle is not independent because for regeneration of RUBP, it has to depend on C3 cycle. Second point, we saw that two molecules of RUBP produce two molecules of PGA plus two molecules of phosphoglycolate. Now here total carbon is 6 and here total carbon is 4. These 6 carbon go to C3 cycle and this 4 carbon forms 3 carbon serine. Once CO2 is released and this 3 carbon forms PGA and again this carbon participates in the C3 cycle. That we have seen in the C2 cycle. So what we conclude with this, that when 4 carbon participate in the C2 cycle, then 3 carbon are being recovered and they are participating in the C3 cycle. So 3 carbon out of 4 carbon, that means 3/4 carbon or 75% carbon is recovered. And 1/4 carbon, that is 25% carbon, is lost in C2 cycle. Third important point, requirement of ATP molecules. To fix one molecule of CO2, C3 cycle require 3 molecule of ATP, but in C2 cycle that requirement is increased to 5 ATP. Now let's see reducing power, the NADPH in C3 cycle that require 2 molecules of NADPH, but in C2 cycle that is 3 molecule of NADPH. Fine. Now fifth point is that productivity and photosynthetic efficiency due to C2 cycle is declined or decreased. Now question, anybody can ask a question that what is the significance of C2 cycle? Significance of C2 cycle. There are arguments. One is that C2 cycle protects plants from photooxidation. In a situation when CO2 availability is low and light intensity and temperature is high. There are some scientific reports wherein mutants were made of Arabidopsis, in which photorespiratory activity was knocked out, and they found this mutant died. But its counterpart, wild type, survived and showed normal growth. Third point, with respect to productivity decline due to C2 cycle. Here also mutants were made not showing photorespiratory activity, but there was no increase in the productivity in the experimental plants. So these point indicates that there are some intrinsic ability or property of C2 cycle which is interlocked with C3 plants, which need to be explored in different direction. There are some plants like C4 and CAM plants which evolved in different direction, by which they concentrate CO2 around Rubisco, and thereby they decrease the rate of photorespiration, or there was no photorespiration. And these two cycles we will discuss in the coming video. Till then, bye bye. Thanks for watching.